Next is Roberto Goto.
There's a clarity about the use, the materials, the architectural character of landscape design that is fairly far advanced. I think we understand what they're planning to do.
Next is Roberto Goto.
So I don't, if they were to do exactly what's shown, I think the ordinary
opportunities for open space. And the open space in front of this building will be lovely, but it's a small open space. It's not really open space for the community. And Beth Rodenstein, I called and left a message. I wanted to discuss this with you last Thursday. I left my phone number and told you I really would like to hear from you. You have not returned my call. Why?
I live right here. What I've asked, because we do, in my experience, this building's here, the courthouse is here, BioPure's here, and there's a lot of retail. Second Street, I don't know how many of you have actually gone to the site and seen it. Second Street is not a street for truck traffic. We do get a lot of truck traffic on Second Street. You hear the noise now at 4:30 in the morning. What I ask is, one of the conditions for the loading dock here, because this is all residential. Everything back here, which wasn't shown in this picture, is residential. And Charles Passage is full. There's lots of residential. What I ask is that you require that the trucks that come in and out of here can only take a right turn. So they're forced to go back out to First Street and not into the residential neighborhood. My other request is, with respect to the entrance here, I ask that on Bench Street you have a no left turn here so that trucks cannot come down Second Street and enter this way. They have to come through First Street and take a right turn to get into the parking space or the loading docks. Because Charles Street here is one way, they can't come up Charles Street. So basically you have them going around here, which is all retail, and not in through the residential neighborhood. That's one of my suggestions. The other thing I also ask is that the loading dock and the trash pickup times be limited to normal business hours during weekdays. I don't know whether or not it's within your jurisdiction or something we have to go through the licensing department, but I ask you to consider that as well. The other issue, which has never been addressed, and as I say, I live here, but from my bedroom, I can see the Amgen blue sign, and I can see the Biogen sign. Everyone wants signage for their R&D building. I'd ask that if you allow signage, or one of the conditions is the signage faces that way and not back into the neighborhood. Because what you're telling me now, if you approve this building, it's not a 45-story building, it's a 65-story building. And every community puts their signage on the very top where the mechanicals are. They don't put it down on the brick, they put it up top where you can see it best. And to have flashing lights across the street, I don't think was what anybody intended. So I asked, as one of the conditions is, when they ask for signage, that it face the other way. And I also strongly ask you to consider the shadowing effect and the noise impact of 65 feet of mechanicals plus the four steps that no one has told us how high those are going to go over and above the 65 feet and what its effect is on the residential neighborhood. Thank you.
We are concerned that in the plans that they showed today, that the bicycle parking has been moved some distance from the entries in both the R&D and in the residential building, rendering the bicycle facilities impractical. I think it's important, we think it's important that bicycling be made as easy and comfortable and practical as possible for it to really work and happen. I believe I heard the architect tonight say that they're moving the bicycle racks back closer to the entrances, but that is a critical concern for my committee. Thank you.
sure if I'm sitting there, I'd have people looking at me like, what are you doing here? So it benefits the building more than it benefits the neighbors. And we asked them and they said that tearing down decrepit buildings, replacing them with new buildings is a public benefit. Once again, more of a benefit for them than for us. The trees are the same way. And I don't see anything that benefits the neighborhood over the developer in this site. And they talk about green space and connections to the river. And I can tell you just from personal experience, a few people here are tired of me telling this story. Thanksgiving morning, going to my mother's house, I drove down Charles Street, Cambridge Park Road, and stopped at a green light. And the reason I did that is because a driver of a 40-foot semi-oil truck thought it was a waste of time to stop at a red light and let me pass. If I had gone on that green light, I would not be alive today. And when you try to cross Land Boulevard, that's what you have happen at that stretch of land. The traffic is moving way too fast for any pedestrian to be crossing at Charles or as Hurley crosses down by the mall. It's just too dangerous to cross. So saying that this development gives any kind of a connection to the river just doesn't wash. And my concern with the building, which is described as 45 feet, but as has been said, is actually 65 feet. I know that a lot of my neighbors dislike the design of it. They feel it's too slab-sided and too much glass. I actually don't mind. I sort of like the design of the building, except the mechanicals, the extra 20 feet on the top, to me looks like one giant cinder block. It's a hideously unattractive top onto a relatively beautiful building below it. So I would just ask you to question the design of the rooftop mechanicals. There has to be a way to do something that looks a little bit better than what we saw in this rendering here. Thank you.
I think echo partially what people have said previously. I think in general, there's no way that anything that's going to be built here is going to comply with overall noise regulations in the neighborhood. I think you can take a reading anywhere you want in regard to the current noise ordinance around here. And the entire neighborhood is already out of compliance. And along with the noise ordinance and several other density issues that we're running into in the community in general, along with this specific project, as long as we continue to look at projects on a onesie-twosie basis, isolated from all the other projects, we're going to get at least some sort of conditional compliance. But when you layer everything together with this project, with Alexandria, with the eminent development of North Point and the rest of what's going on in the neighborhood, if we keep looking at things in a microcosm instead of in a macrocosm, what we're going to end up with is an utterly unhealthy level of noise in the neighborhood. And I'm not talking about normal urban noise. I'm talking about an unhealthy level of noise, particularly around R&D type buildings and the mechanicals that are involved. Same for overall density. I don't have, you know, I think the development, particularly of this parcel of the R&D building and the Rogers and First Street parcel, are great. I'd like to see this turned into a park. But overall density, both from this project and from the development going on in the neighborhood, the infrastructure is already stressed beyond what it can accommodate in the neighborhood. The major crosstown streets, 3rd Street, Cardinal Medeiros, and to some degree 1st Street, are already stressed beyond what they can take in terms of infrastructure. Nobody's presented us with any traffic studies on what the additional car trips from this project and for Alexandria, and for the rest of the Kendall Square development, and for North Point are going to cause them in the neighborhood. And again, if we continue to look at them in isolated incidents, one project by one project by one project, we're going to find conditional compliance on a project by project basis. But when you take it all as a whole and look at the entirety of what's being developed in the neighborhood, you will find overall density in terms of cars, in terms of noise, in terms of environmental impact, it is beyond what the current infrastructure in the neighborhood and the region can support. Parking, personally, without sounding completely radical, I'd like to see all the parking go away. I'd like to see it disappear and force the people in these buildings to take public transportation. We're beyond critical mass in parking in the neighborhood. The battle has been lost, residential or commercially. If we're going to continue to develop an intelligent, sustainable infrastructure, we need to get people in a hard way to take public transportation. the infrastructure and the environment can't take any more cars in the neighborhood. It's simply just not going to work. That's it. Thank you.
Next is Roberto Goto. Roberta. Next is Roberto Goto.